Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video on Winter 25 release. So in this video, I'm going to talk about a feature which came in few releases back, but in this release, this feature is becoming very powerful and the feature is called the flow repeater component. So with this flow repeater component, you can do a lot of stuff. I have a couple of videos in my YouTube channel which I'll show you so that you can go through that and to understand the basics of the flow repeater component. But in this release, if you have the data available, you can pre-populate your flow repeater component so that you don't need to do the same thing again and again. So without any delay, let's explore this powerful feature in a pre-release org together. So before we start, I'd like to let you know that I have published a couple of videos in my YouTube channel about this flow repeater component, which you can go through to understand the basics of the flow repeater component. And also there is a use case which I've implemented using this powerful component. So as you can see in the screen, if you go to my YouTube channel, the name of my YouTube channel is Technical Potpourri. So if you go to my YouTube channel and if you search for flow repeater, you should be able to find these two videos. One is what is a flow repeater component and another is use your flow repeater component to collect information and create records. This is a use case which I've implemented using this powerful component. I will put the link in the description of this video as well as on the top right corner so that you can go through that and understand the basic of this repeater component. Okay, so with that, here I am in my pre-release org. So first thing that I'm going to do, I am going to go to my setup and start creating the flow. So let's type flow here and let's start creating a new flow. Start from scratch and it is going to be a screen flow. What I'm going to do in this flow, I'm going to make the data available and I'm going to pre-populate that data in the flow repeater component. So for that, what my use case is, if I go to any account, I am going to fetch all the contacts associated with that account. So for that, in my flow builder, I will start with a get element, get records, and let's give a name as get all contact and account ID matches with the variable, and the variable is basically the record ID. It will be of type text and I will make this available for input. So basically when I'm going to make this flow in the account page layout, the account ID will be passed to this variable record ID, and with that variable I'm going to fetch all the contacts where the account ID matches with the past account ID. So I'm going to fetch all the records. Perfect. Let's save this flow. Winter 25 flow repeater, save. Now with my contacts available, I am going to start with the screen element. Let's give your name as first screen. In this one, I am going to add the repeater. So in the component section, if you search with repeater, you'll find this repeater one. So let's drag it here. And inside this one, I am going to add the fields which I want to display or pre-populate. So as I have created the first screen and added the repeater component, in the repeater component, there is, let's give a name as contact repeater. And in the data source, this is new. In the data source, I am going to give the data, the list of contacts which I have collected in the previous element. Through is the contacts from get all contacts. So now repeater element is already have the data sources. With that data sources available, what I'm going to do, I'm going to add the element which I want to show here. So for that, let's add the full name. Now the default value of the full name will be the repeater pre-populated items, under which you'll find this one. And here you will find the full name. Similar way, I want to put the email also. So if I put email, in the default value, I am going to get the, under this repeater pre-populated items, I'm going to fetch that, and here there should be an email. And then click on done. Let's save. Let's save as new version. And then activate the flow. Now let's bring this flow under this account page layout. So here I'm in inside account. So let's edit this page. Let's create a new tab here. It's going to be a custom tab. Let's say all contacts and done. Under this all contacts, let me bring the flow. And here, let's give the name as Winter 25 Flow Repeater. And then click on, and then here in the record ID, pass the record ID. Click on save. And if I go back now and see this new tab, clicking on that, I can see that my flow repeater component is already populated 4 times. With each of these, one is pre-populated with the contacts that I have inside this account. This feature was not there before. This feature is coming up with Winter 25 release, and I believe this feature is going to be a very helpful feature because you don't need to click on add and include all the contacts. If you have the data available, pass that data to the flow repeater and let the flow repeater do the job and bring that many components with the data, with the collection data. So this is a very powerful feature. I'm 100% sure that this feature is going to help a lot of admins, a lot of developers to implement new use cases in their project. So now the question might come to your mind is that whatever action I'm doing on this page, how do I know about those actions? Like, for example, if I change something here, right? How do I know? If I add a new contact, how do I know? If I delete a contact, how do I know? Basically, what are the different actions that are possible on the repeater component, and how can I track those actions? How can I get those elements where I have taken some action? So basically, this flow repeater component will give you 4 output variables. One output variable will contain all the elements which are pre-populated and the items that you have manually added. So in this case, we have 4. If I add any 2, that variable will contain all 6 elements. So that's the variable number 1. Variable number 2 is basically all the elements which are pre-populated. For example, this 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the pre-populated items. So variable number 2 will only contain the pre-populated items. Variable number 3 will only contain the item that you have manually added. So if I add any 2 here or any 3 here, variable number 3 will contain only those 3 manually added elements. And the variable number 4 is basically if I have removed any item. For example, out of this 4, if I have removed these 2, then variable number 4 will contain those removed element. So let's see that in action. So for that, let's create a loop. So inside, let's give a name. Inside loop, I am going to go through the first screen. This is the repeater. And as I was telling, these are the 4 variables: added items, all items, pre-populated items, and the removed items. So let's start with the all items. It is going through all items. All items basically means added pre-populated items and any new items that you have added. So let's create an assignment. Let's create a variable called a contact record type contact, and let's type it here, a contact dot full name equals to, this is a loop, full name, similar way, a contact dot email equals to loop dot email dot value, and then put this one in another assignment, put this single contact in a list of contacts. So all contacts, here create a new variable again, give the name as contacts, and record, it will be type contact, and it will allow multiple values, all contacts add contact. So loop is basically going through that, do the assignment, and finally storing that single contact into a list of contacts. Once the loop is done, let's add one more screen element and give this as a name as second screen. And inside the second screen, I'm going to add a data table. This is also a very powerful component. I have a couple of videos where I've implemented many use cases using data table. I'll put the link in the description as well as on the top right corner so that you can go through those, but it's a very powerful one. So data table, let's give a name as data table, and here in the source collection, let's give the contacts and I need to still populate the columns. So the first column, let's put the name as full name, and the second column, let's put the email. So let's configure columns. In the second one, let's put email. Done. So called full name and email. Let's click on done. Save as new version and then activate. Now let's go back here. Go back to this one. All contacts. Definitely all these four contacts are pre-populated. So I'm going to add a new one. Let's add the new one as Shane Warne. And then if I click on next, I am already seeing all the four which was pre-populated and along with the new one which I just added, because in this one I am using the variable which is the all items. Now let's remove all items. Let's get rid of all items and from all items, let's add the added items. Added items means only the items that you have manually added. So click on save and then activate. Go back here and go to the all contacts. Let's add the new contact. And click on next. This time it's all this. It's only contents the element that I have manually added, because the variable I'm using is the added items. Okay, with that, let's add the pre-populated items. And as you can already understand, pre-populated items will contain only the items which are pre-populated. So again, go back here, refresh. I hope I've activated, yes. And all contacts, already four are pre-populated. Here, let's add Shane Warne, and then if I click on next, it's only giving me the four pre-populated items, not the items that I've manually added. And the last one, which is a little tricky, is the removed items. So in case of removed items, you will not get the properties or individual properties of that record, rather you will get the ID. Let's understand a use case where, let's say I have account and contact, and they are connected through account contact relationship, right? Now in this flow, if I show you all those 10 or 15 account contact relationship, right, and then your use case is, okay, I want to remove and contact from this account contact relationship. So if you remove, it doesn't mean that you are basically deleting the record at the back end. It means on that account contact relationship record, you are making that from active to inactive. So for that reason, the remove will give you the ID of the record. And with that ID, you can do your post-processing work. For example, in the use case I told you before, for example, you can remove the is active checkbox from the account contact relationship and making that record inactive. So that contact is not part of that account anymore. So if you use the remove items, then you will not get this full name. Instead of, you will get only the ID. This is not possible. So here, everything looks good. Only here, you will not have full name or email. Rather, you will have the ID. Done, save as new version, and activate. Now if I go back here, all contacts, let's say I remove this one and the last one, so I have only two. If I go to the next one, I'm getting two IDs. Why it's not working? Let's see that again. Looks good. I'm still showing email. Okay, this is wrong. It should be ID. And I need to click on done. It's done. Save as new version. And click on activate. If I go back here, refresh. All contacts, let's remove the first one and then this time third one and click on next. I'm getting only the two record IDs which are deleted, and here I can use this record ID to do any type of post-processing work. For example, if there is an active checkbox, I can mark this active checkbox, uncheck for these two record, right? So this is a way how we can use this enhanced flow repeater component. If we have the data available, we can pre-populate the data with this flow repeater component. At the same time, this component will give us four variables which contains either the all elements or all data that we have added, including the pre-populated and the manually added data. Or the second variable is only the pre-populated data, third variable is only the manually added data, and the fourth variable is the removed data. So this enhanced component will give us four variables to handle different scenarios in our implementation. So if you like this video, I highly recommend, please subscribe to my channel, hit a like icon, and please share this video with your friends, with your colleagues, so that they also know about this powerful feature. And please subscribe to my channel, because in next few days I'm going to publish more contents about new features that are coming up along with winter 25 release. So if you have subscribed, you will be notified the moment the video becomes online. Till then, thank you. Bye bye.